23 తారీఖు ఆగస్ట్ సినిమా రిలీజ్ అయ్యింది మీ అందరూ తెలిసినట్టు అండ్ టీంలో ఎవరూ కూడా 23 నుంచి ఇవాళ వరకు కూడా కలిసి ఎవరూ లేవు ఒక్కొక్కరు ఒక దారిలో ప్రమోట్ చేయటం కానీ లేకపోతే ఒక్కొక్కరు యూనో ఈ సినిమా గురించి కష్టపడడం జరుగుతుంది మధు గారు హూస్ విత్ అస్ టుడే చాలా బిజీగా ఉన్నారు ఆమె సో షీ కుడ్ కమ్ ఫర్ ఎ డే ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ అండ్ వచ్చినాక ఏంటంటే టీం మొత్తం ఒకసారి కలుద్దాం మంచి సినిమాని ఎప్పుడు ఆదరిస్తున్న ప్రేక్షకులు ఈ సినిమాని ఆదరిస్తూ అనేది ఈ సక్సెస్కు మెయిన్ కారణాలండి మేము జనరల్గా అన్ని సినిమాలకు కష్టపడుతున్నాం టీం అంతా కష్టపడుతాం అది ఒక ఎత్తు అవుతే ఈ రెండు మెయిన్ కారణాలు అట్లాగే మీ ఈ సినిమా చేద్దాం అనుకున్నప్పుడు కాస్టింగ్లో మిగతా క్యారెక్టర్స్ కూడా యాప్ట్ క్యారెక్టర్స్ యాప్ట్గా ఉండాలి అని చెప్పి చాలా కష్టపడ్డాం అంటే మీరు సినిమా చూస్తున్నారు కాబట్టి మధు క్యారెక్టర్ కానీ లేకపోతే రోహిణి కానీ లేకపోతే రవిబాబు కానీ అండ్ రావు రమేష్ కానీ ఇవన్నిటికి కూడా సడన్గా ఈ క్యారెక్టర్కి ఇట్లా ఈయన చేస్తే బాగుంటుందని అనుకోలే చాలా చూసి ఆలోచించి ఎవరైతే యాప్ట్ అవుతారనేది డిసైడ్ చేసి పెట్టిన క్యారెక్టర్లు ఎస్పెషలీ మధు క్యారెక్టర్కి అయితే మటు చాలా కష్టపడ్డాం అంటే ఒక యంగ్ మదర్ కావాలి ఈషా కొత్త అమ్మాయి అమ్మకి తగ్గట్టు కొంచెం ఉండాలి ఎవరైతే బాగుంటారని చెప్పి చాలా వెతికాం వెతికినాక ఒక సడన్గా ఒకరోజు రోజా మధు అయితే ఎట్లా బాగుంటుంది అట్లా వచ్చింది థాట్ దెన్ మధు అని అనుకున్న తర్వాత మధు ఇప్పుడు ఏం చేస్తుంది ఇప్పుడు అడిగితే ఒప్పుకుంటుందా విల్ షీ అగ్రీ టు డూ దిస్ అనేది ఎక్స్సైడ్ ఒకసారి 1 వీక్ జరిగింది దాన్ని ఎసెట్సి ఒకసారి అడిగి చూద్దాం ఏమో మహావతి ఏమంటుంది నేను ఇప్పుడు సినిమాలు చేయట్లేదు అంటుంది దానికి మించి ఉంది కదా ఒకసారి ట్రై చేద్దామని అడిగాం బట్ నో షీ వాజ్ వెరీ పాజిటివ్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ ఒక నేషనల్ ఈవినింగ్ డైరెక్టర్ అవటం ఫస్ట్ డే షూటింగ్ చేసిన 10 నిమిషాల్లో మాకు ఆ భయం పోయింది మాతో అంత బాగా కలిసిపోయింది తను అండ్ షూటింగ్ ఆమె చేసిన 10 రోజులైనా కానీ చాలా కంఫర్టబుల్గా చేసాం అండ్ నేను ఇట్లాంటి ఆర్టిస్టులు ఈ యాటిట్యూడ్ ఉన్న ఆర్టిస్టులు చాలా అరుదండి ఇవాళ రోజుల్లో అండ్ ఐఎమ్ రియలీ హ్యాపీ దట్ నో వీ హ్యాడ్ ద ఆప్షన్ టు వర్క్ విత్ హర్ ఎందుకంటే ఈ సినిమాలో పర్టికులర్గా ఒకరు కనెక్ట్ అవ్వటం అంటే జరగదు ఎందుకంటే ఒక్కొక్కరు ఒక్కొక్క క్యారెక్టర్ కలెక్ట్ అయ్యారు ఒక్కొక్కరు ఒక విధంగా కనెక్ట్ అయ్యారు సినిమాకి బట్ మధుకు వచ్చిన క్యారెక్టర్కి వచ్చిన కనెక్షన్ చాలా ఎక్కువ అండి
అండ్ థ్యాంక్ యూ దాము గారు ఫర్ ఆల్ దోస్ వండర్ఫుల్ థింగ్స్ ఐ అండర్స్టూడ్ అబౌట్ 70% ఆఫ్ వాట్ యూ సెడ్ అండ్ ఐ థింక్ దే వర్ ఆల్ నైస్ When I left the industry, I was just an artist. When I came back, I became a senior artist. So that adjustment is also is quite amusing. I have truly enjoyed being back, and especially in this unit, in this place in Hyderabad, with all these lovely people, because this was not what I had planned for myself. I thought I will do some Hindi films somewhere there in Bombay. I thought I'll do Tamil films. I never thought I would do a Telugu film, but it came to me and it came to me so beautifully. So many times I said I don't want to do, but they never let me go. That's the beauty when sometimes things happen, you yourself don't know the good things that's coming to you and you're pushing it away. But people are so wonderful. Mohanji was so, he called me many times, explained the role, Jaganji and everybody, they Once I heard the story, and of course I wanted to be a part of this film because I wanted to be associated with somebody who was an award winner. And I know I didn't make the wrong choice. Thank you for having me here. When they said Telugu film and a mother role, I didn't even want to hear about it the second time. But then I was given a small description of the role and the fact that this lady is, firstly, even though she's a mother, She doesn't have to dress like a mother, she just has to look like I am, and I am a mother. So it was not so difficult playing the role. And secondly, she is wants to be an actress, movie actress, TV actress. And that's what I want to do when I'm sitting in my house with my children and their homework. I'm always dreaming about this. When will I do that film? When will I do that film? When will Mani Sir make Roja 2? All those dreams, everybody is making sequels today. I'm just waiting for Mani Sir to say, okay, I'm going to make one sequel with Roja. So when I'm having all those kind of thoughts, I am exactly playing the role that I am. It's not a role. It's like this mother who finds herself with a lot of time and wants to be an actress and she becomes an actress, and in the end she's well appreciated for it, because you know, and yet it was real, all those people and all of us, when we do those scenes, it is not that we are trying to be unreal, it is just the projection, the TV and the camera, that makes it look somehow not so true. So I really enjoyed wearing those lenses and the hairdo and doing all that. I enjoyed that. And that Saas Bahu role, which all of us think it's our right to criticize, but it's not easy and it's a lot of hard work there. So I enjoyed every bit of the role that I did in this film. Honestly, in this film, when I did the mother role, I know it's a mother role, but I never felt like a mother. My shooting for this film was for 7 days, I think. And those 7 days were all my scenes. And each one of my scenes has had something that I had to do in it. I felt very like, I actually felt like a heroine on those 7 days. I felt that these scenes are revolving around me and I am doing something and I'm performing. I didn't feel like a mother standing and being a part of what is going on. I felt that I was the center of what was going on. So I did not feel that now from a heroine, I became a mother. That is as far as the role goes. And as far as the treatment which I got from the production house, from the producer, from the director, from the co-artist, they treated me absolutely with so much respect. And sometimes I didn't even know whether I deserved that kind of respect. They gave me a status of a senior artist, which sometimes I myself, I don't know if I deserve that. So I never really felt that I was being relegated or sidelined. I felt totally in the middle of it all, and I'm so, so grateful for that feeling. You're asking me if the advice that I gave the heroine, do I feel like that? I am the mother of the heroine, but I didn't do a mother role, like the way we all know. This is so progressive. The director seems to understand the relationships and the way it is today, in relation to today's life so beautifully, that I totally enjoyed. I identified, this is how I am at home with my children. When I'm angry, I tell my children off. I'm not that one of those sweet, lovely, sacrificing mothers. I can be a devil. And then when I'm happy, when I'm feeling all this joy, I go back and feel lovely. So these are things that happen in every home, which is not projected in our Indian cinema. Mother has always been like the sweet mother who sacrifices herself. But life has changed, movies have changed, and audience have changed. And they can accept these realities and appreciate them. And therefore, I think I appreciate Mohanji's whole angle to this whole, all these characterizations, and proud to be a part of it. In Telugu, for definitely this is a comeback. I have done little things in the other languages, in Hindi and Tamil. But definitely in the Telugu platform, this is my comeback and a proud comeback. I'm very happy to call myself a comeback and hoping to find really a nice place from here on. My family, as in my husband and my new family, they are not from the film. So for me to firstly take their support was a very big deal, because they don't understand that why I should leave Bombay and why I should work so much, and they really can't understand. So it took me a long time to make them feel that it is not that I want to be busy or I want to earn money or any of that. It is just that everybody has a talent, or at least they think they have one. So some people have the talent in the kitchen, they make lovely food, some like to. For me, this is the only place where I feel I know or I can get better. In any other place, I'm lost. I'm always looking at somebody else to help me out in any other place. Only on the platform where you need me to perform as an artist, I feel I'm learning, I'm confident, I love it. When I worked with all the great directors in the past, I felt very new, and I was, I was in awe of all the directors. Whether it was K. Balchandar ji or Raghavendra Rao ji or Mani Ratnam ji, I never questioned. I was in awe of them because I knew they were great directors. So whatever they said, I tried to do that. With Mohan ji, I already knew that if he had won such a big recognition in our country, he was as it is as a creative director, must be wonderful. But when I saw him, I realized he was so much, you know, young, and having studied abroad or whatever it is, his thought process were very liberal. So, and I could actually now ask and understand With the other directors, I never asked, I never understood. They asked me to do something and I blindly did it. Now I'm at a stage where I could ask and my sensibilities were satisfied and I felt a different kind of a rapport and a different kind of respect for Mohanji. Even though I would like to say that I'm sure he's of the same caliber as all those wonderful people I've worked with in the past. The movie is made by the director and before that by the story person and after that by the editor. And I never question their sensibility. Once I've chosen to be a part of a film, I never ask why and what. So whatever the movies, if they are good, if people have liked me or if they have liked the movie, I would honestly like to give the credit to the director. I used to play, but once or twice my pranks turned out to be very sour, you know, not nice. So then I made it a point because what I think funny, most people don't think it's funny. So don't want to hurt people. People get hurt by pranks sometimes. So I gave up. These are all very tall claims. I conquer and all that. It's always nice to talk in hindsight. Like today, we all say, not I, but all of you say that the movie is successful. All of you say that I am appreciated. So I can come here and talk and, you know, in the same way, when things happen, it's nice to talk after it than to say I've come to conquer and all that, you know. It's not nice. My children are very young, lovely little girls. They are in school and they are in the standard 7th and 5th. This is a very scary topic because I'm a mother of two girls and the more I hear and read about these ghastly things, it only makes me so scared. And honestly, I've become numb to this topic. I don't make a statement. I don't wish to talk about it because people who need to talk, I think, are raising their voices and I think necessary measures are being taken in the right places. I pray and I hope that. More than that, I'm appalled, I'm scared, I'm nervous, and I can't believe where we've come to. So it's very scary.